There we go. Okay, so far we've been talking about pathological parasites, but not all parasites are bad. In my lab, we look at parasites as a way of treatment against autoimmune or inflammatory diseases. More specifically, in my research, I'm looking to them as a treatment against rheumatoid arthritis. But first, what is rheumatoid arthritis? I don't know why this is not changing. Sorry, it's not changing my slides for some reason.
Okay. Try using a side arrow instead of a mouse click.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm doing. Okay. And now it moved too fast. There we go. So what is rheumatoid arthritis? Rheumatoid arthritis is it affects 1% of the world, and it has a very high incidence in Canada, affecting one in every 100 Canadians. Not only this, but it's characterized by a lot of pain and inflammation of the joint, stopping people from normal day activities. And also there's no current optimal therapies available. And the reason to understand that a little bit better, first you have to understand your immune response a little. So there's two main ways that your immune response works. And there's Th1 and Th2. So Th1 is cellular immunity. And it's basically the type of immune response that reacts to pathogens such as viruses. And then you have Th2, which is humoral immunity, which attacks anything that's extracellular pathogen, such as parasites. So when they're in balance, your body is healthy. But when there's some regulation of any one of the two, then you run into problems. In the case of the majority of autoimmune responses, as well as rheumatoid arthritis, you have an imbalance such as Th1 is super reactive, causing your body to think that your body itself is a pathogen. And so it starts attacking your joints, which causes all of the symptoms that we see in this disease. Current therapies focus on increasing Th2. However, they increase it too much, and this causes other issues, such as making you susceptible to infection. Now, it has been theorized and proven in other autoimmune diseases that Helminth treatment is able to actually bring a balance when there is an autoimmune response and have both of these two immune responses in balance. So now you have a healthy person, in theory. So that is the basis of the majority of my research. And I specifically focus on not only the parasites, but the products that they secrete. And it is from these products that they will be able to find the critical compounds that then we could be potentially using against rheumatoid arthritis. Now, the very first thing to understand though is how do we even obtain these products? So we look into the life cycle of the parasite. And the one that I work with is called Helminth polygyrus. And this parasite is already known to modulate inflammation. So we already know it lowers inflammation in other models of disease. It is a very well-established parasitic model, and it has a very direct life cycle. And I focus specifically on obtaining the larvae and the adults. And just so you can have a clearer view of what this looks like, this on the left is the egg of the parasite. Then we wait a couple of days, and then we're able to obtain the larvae. We have to wait for them to mature, and then we are able to infect the mice, and we're able to obtain the adults from the intestine. And here you can see the intestine with all of the parasites inside of it. Then we obtain the parasites, and we go through several rigorous washes in order to just get the parasites and nothing else, because we just want them and their products that they secrete for our in order to go through our next step, which is obtaining the products. So once they've been sitting there for a while, we'll look into the magic of biochemistry. So I'm able to send my products to another lab, which separates them by size. So now you have small molecules and big molecules. And these big molecules can be used for other experiments, but my main focus is small molecules. So they go into further separation by polarity. And these small molecules are the ones that I'm looking into for the treatments against rheumatoid arthritis. So, okay, now we have the parasites and the products. What's next? I can move on to my experimental groups. And over here, I have four main groups. The first one is a naive control, that is a healthy group of animals. And the next three are all have been induced with rheumatoid arthritis. The first one will be a control disease group. And then after that, the other two groups, one is treated with a parasite and one is treated with excreted secreted products. And then we want to see, is this able to revert these joints and we in a way that we can see back into a healthy animal? And the first thing again is to set up these control groups. So over here on the left is a naive healthy group. And we clearly see there is no inflammatory cells in the knee. The cells that you see here are red blood cells. So there's no, inflammatory cells. And in our disease group, we can see several neutrophils and macrophages, which are inflammatory cells, and they show that there's a disease, which is what we expect from the rheumatoid arthritis model. So good, we have now clearly set up our naive control and healthy group from our disease group. The next step of my project is the one that I am in currently is, okay, now we have our other two groups, and we will be treating these disease groups with the parasite or the excreted secreted products. And the theory is that they will decrease this inflammation that we observe in when they have arthritis. Another way that we're able to see this too is through microscopy. And here on the left, we have what a healthy knee looks like when there's no arthritis. And this is the vessel, and the everything black around it is the muscle. On the right, we see again the vessel, and all of these blue dots that you see are all inflammatory cells. So again, we can very clearly see a difference between rheumatoid arthritis mice and a healthy mouse. So once we treat with the parasites, again, our theory is that we will go back to what this picture on the left looks like. And what's very cool is that not only can I just look at them in the microscope, I can actually look at the flow of the cells through the vessels of the mice. And this is through light microscopy. And again, this in blue is the vessel, and in red are inflammatory cells, and they're doing their normal thing. They're just looking at the environment. Now, when there's inflammation, the cells start to roll and attach and go through the vessel into the muscle. And this is what happens during inflammation. So again, with our treatments, we hope that we'll be able to go back to a normal vessel. And basically, in summary, rheumatoid arthritis is very common and debilitating disease, and there is no available long-term treatments. And it is our hopes that these products or the parasites will be able to decrease inflammation of this disease, and hopefully this will lead to new rheumatic disease therapies. Thank you. And also have a thanks to my lab and the scholarships and my professor that helped me through this project.